I had double shoulder surgery. I had two torn labrums that they told me were 10 years old. So basically, I've had them ever since I started training. So I've never known what it's like to wrestle with good shoulders. Yeah, I can do this. I never could do that before, like out here. Like, I have all range of motion that I was very limited with for a very long time, and I put off for years and years and years and years because I didn't want to step away. I think, one, because I loved it, but two, because I knew that on the other side of that there was gonna be some things I had to come face to face with. But now I feel great.
Hey, you're so good.
Oh, oh, I missed you.
How are you?
My hands are so cool. I got an ice. Where did I get ice? When you step away from this, especially because this lifestyle is so fast paced, it's go, 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 on to the next thing, on to the next thing. I used wrestling even though I loved it. Like, I loved it from the moment that I was wheeled away for surgery, and I still love it. Like, I've never had any problem with wrestling or my job, but I used it as a distraction to kind of not have to face some things that I should have faced a long time ago. You know, I do have anxiety, and I suffer from ADHD and depression and stuff like that, and so it was stuff that I no longer had a distraction for. It was right in front of me. So I got help. I saw a doctor and a therapist, and I feel incredible, and I feel great.
I am very much looking forward to using wrestling as what it was always meant to be. Which is not a distraction anymore. It's my purpose. And showing the world who I am, who a healthy version of me really is.
Today is the day that Monday Night Raw. It's been a long time, and I'd only worked with the company for like a year and a half when I got hurt. And I look a lot different, you know? I mean, I have different colored hair, I have some new tattoos. There is a fear there. I think that that's the scariest part, is the unknown of where I fit in. But that's also the most empowering part about, if they don't have a place for me, I'm gonna make a place, you know? When you're on the road to recovery, I feel like you have like a goal in mind and like a day in mind. Like that's the end result. Like that's where what it's all for, you know? And then you build it up in your head. And then in that moment, it can go the exact way that you planned it, which very rarely does it ever. But I just hope that whatever I do and however I come back, that, you know, that I remind people exactly why I'm here and who I am, and that now that I thought I was good before, I have two good shoulders now. You ain't seen nothing yet.
What the hell are we witnessing?